DLC privileges. The 599.
The degenerate sortie characters.
degenerates, they have capabilities, you know. Looks like Byleth is already ranking up some damage.
Yeah, that's an amazing start from that Byleth to keep on capitalizing off that air. So, Major, how do you feel about this matchup?
I feel like there's going to be some crazy wacky shenanigans and a lot of shield breaking.
Definitely. I don't really have
And the wing is out.
Character knowledge about these two characters, so
well,
I'm going in blind, especially with that Sephiroth.
I actually know a lot more of Sephiroth. I kind of made him. It's just that Sephiroth is very versatile. Like, especially his neutral B.
The only thing I know about Byleth that she got that little wacky tether and she hits really hard.
Well, both of them are heavy hitters when you think of it. It's just that their matchup needs to be a little more worthwhile.
With Sephiroth, you gotta focus a little bit more on that spacing.
Well, that's what all his specials are like. Each and every single one of them is him spacing out. Well, except his elbow special.
I call Byleth the Brawlhalla character because she just got special moves like from Brawlhalla.
Okay. Well, let's see if the wing will be a saving grace. As you know, if Sephiroth does any smash attack, it gives him super armor.
Does it?
Yes, it does. If the wing is out.
I did not know that. You're teaching me more Sephiroth knowledge.
I mean, if you want, I could fight you with Sephiroth, but I know I'm terrible with it. It's 2-2. Oh man, Sephiroth already does some damage up in there.
Hopefully he can probably capitalize on that rage, but...
Well, I mean, it's not like the wing makes you immortal. This ain't no Joker Arsen thing we're talking here.
Yeah, but 114 rage, that could really build up, especially with that heavy-hitting projectile attack. I don't know what it's called.
Well, I believe the arrow can be reflected. If not, it breaks the reflector. But at least both options will keep Sephiroth safe.
Yeah, definitely.
Ooh.
That was a good very unique punish, but either way it still worked.
Well, I mean, if it was the other way around, he would have lost the stock too. So I guess he wants to keep that stock with him.
Yeah, definitely. That Sephiroth now does not have to approach. He can just play his little far away neutral game however long he wants.
I mean, with the Masamune, he has a really long
and now he has a good game.
And now the game is even. 1-1 with barely any damage for any of the opponents.
Amazing nair. That was a nice nair conversion.
You sound a good plan.
Good 2-frame zoning.
Ooh, a counter right there. Will the Giga Blast land? Does it. But he goes in with
that's
the...
That's a very unique option, but either way, it's still good.
I mean, first travel. Gerald takes
yeah,
the game with 1-0.
It would have been really, really minus, and that would have been a free punish. So. Good job on that Sephiroth.
Sephiroth's a good player. There's a village you're going against a Min-Min. Can't be options, can't be king, queen, going against.
Yeah, but unless I ain't nothing interesting happening over there, just 2 zoners.
Well, yeah, 2 zoners, one with good distance, the other one with good power. Both, really, but...
Let's see what these guys are gonna pick.
Alright, character selection for the winner's bracket.
Switch characters.
Oh?
Oh, and he's switching to Corrin now.
Not yet. Dark Pit!
Finally, he busted out the Dark Pit.
He busted out the Dark Pit.
If you guys didn't know, Dark Pit is his main, so we can start seeing some saucy Dark Pit action.
Mm-hmm. Oh man, spacing and reflecting. It's gonna be fun.
Probably not. I think they team up. It's going to be a weird matchup for the Dark Pit. Even though he gets really good momentum once he breaks the neutral and his advantage state, as soon as he starts getting blown up by that circle, it's going to be a big problem. Good attempt from two frame.
And already a good start with the Sephiroth.
It's going to be really hard for that pitcher to try to get in, especially since that Sephiroth isn't going to try to rush down.
I'm surprised the wing isn't out yet. Well, I do
have amazing read. Yeah.
Good read. I got to remember that it doesn't have a set damage.
Setup's going on with that Sephiroth. It even killed him.
But it seems like if he's good with the sniping, he can.
Good job.
2-1 with Dark Pit having a good stock lead.
Pit just needs to start taking the season out.
And hit with a Giga Blast.
He is alive, gets a good DI. And amazing tech.
But it wasn't enough.
Still dies, but still an amazing tech either way.
It's an even match. This match can either break or make or break the game.
Honestly, this could be either person's game.
Well, yeah, that's what I mean when I say make or break.
Like, you made the correct choice picking that Dark Pit. Definitely did.
The edginess wins. Oh man, we could have said it's Edgeward versus Edgeward. Am I right?
Yeah.
Alright. Over here at the loser's bracket, I did notice that our villager player has won the game. And it looks like we have a Rob versus a Zelda. Ooh, interesting. They're both ranking up a good amount of damage here. I wish I could see how much stock they have, but I do not have that good eyesight over there.
You got 20/20 vision.
I mean, if I did have 20/20, I would not be wearing these, now would I?
I mean, you could get better glasses.
But I noticed they have 3 stocks, so I guess I'm believing they started the game already. Okay, so back here is same characters.
My favorite stage.
Smashville. Why do they call it Smashville if it's an Animal Crossing stage?
That is a good question. I don't play Animal Crossing, so I don't know, but...
I mean, I play Animal Crossing, and there's no such thing as Smashville. If any... Wow, good start!
That is a
Spike.
Really intense way to start the stock. Start the game.
Yes!
It's going to be an uphill battle from here, but...
These players are going to go
it
all
is, it's not an impossible match.
And the openers are broken. I wonder, what would happen if the two of them just reflected that to each other? One of their reflectors would have to break now, wouldn't it?
I mean, I don't think Sephiroth's counter is a reflector. I think it's just a regular counter.
No, it's,
nice
it's a reflector. This is a reflector too.
And Sephiroth is not going to approach at all. He honestly does
one. Basically, Sephiroth has his whole match in his hands. Yeah, if he plays
this,
the cards
right.
His,
this is his game. No need to overextend.
He could end this right now with a flick of his wrist.
Miss opportunity for that finish.
Ooh, is that it? Oh no, Darvick's still in the game!
Oh, is that?
That is not game, it's not ready yet. Not over yet. Luckily, he didn't get three stocked. Darkpit finally finds an opening. Get real close now.
It's not over yet.
It's over.
It's over yet. Commentator's curse. That was an amazing set from both of those players.
And Gerald wins the entire set.